This episode is brought to you by My Astronomy Channel. This week, NASA published new astonishing high-definition images of famous pillars of creation. Two 4-light-year-tall columns located in the Eagle Nebula, 7,000 light-years from here, first photographed in 1995. The only problem is that the pillars don't exist. They were destroyed more than 1,000 years ago. I know you're surprised, but wait. Limited by our understanding of reality and time, we look at objects in space as if they were mountains or the ocean. We genuinely perceive these stellar landscapes as something that is up there fixed, secure, rooted in our reality, the solid foundation of our existence. Some people see the work of gods in all this seemingly immutable show. Hence the mythological names of planets, constellations, nebulas, and galaxies, or these pillars of creation. Others just see scientific wonders, a vast cosmic arena in which the Earth is just a tiny mote of dust suspended on a sunbeam. Our diminutive perception of time, the same that makes us think that we are the center of everything, is just an illusion. At the cosmic scale, just like in our individual lives, things move constantly. The architecture of the cosmos is ever-changing. And scientists know, since 2007, only a few years after they were observed, that these gargantuan structures don't exist anymore. They were destroyed, blasted by a supernova that happened 6,000 years ago. With our telescopes, we can see the supernova advancing, unstoppable, destroying everything it touches. From Earth, the shockwave has not reached the pillars of creation yet. For our senses, they are still there, intact. In 1,000 years, there will be one hell of a show. The shockwave is already arriving to the pillars of creation, and just like they were created, they will be destroyed, obliterated by the force of a dead star. When the Hubble picture of the pillars of creation was released in 1995, no one expected to see anything like this. The entire world was astounded that nature could harbor such beauty, previously hidden from human eyes, by an incredible distance. The Eagle Nebula, their location, is an estimated 7,000 light years away. Think about that for a second. Light travels at an incredible speed of 299,800 kilometers per second. To reach the Eagle Nebula, you would have to travel at the speed of light for 7,000 years continuously. So why were the pillars dubbed the Pillars of Creation? Because they are the birthplace of an unforetold number of new stars. The pillars, composed entirely of gas and dust, have such high densities that the resulting gravity causes the gas to contract and form stars. Now, this may surprise some of you. After all, stars are enormous, and it might seem impossible that the pillars could even hope to contain them. Think again. Take a close look at the top of the leftmost pillar, pictured at the right. You see the finger-like extensions at the top? That's the size of our solar system. That should give you an idea of the scale of these gigantic structures. In fact, to describe the length of the pillars, we have to resort to light years. The leftmost pillar is an estimated 4 light years in length. Let's do some math. 60 seconds in a minute, 60 minutes in an hour, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, 4 years. 60 times 60 times 24 times 365 times 4 times 299,800, that's the speed of light, equals 37,817,971,200,000 kilometers. 37.8 trillion kilometers. That's how big these things are. But wait, the pillars of creation have left the best surprise for last. If there was some way that you could fly up to the Hubble right now and attach a small eyepiece onto it, you'd be able to see the pillars. Pretty basic, right? So let's recap what we know so far. We know how far away they are. We know how big they are. We know that you can even see them, given the proper equipment. We also know that they don't exist anymore. I will say this one more time. In fact, it may be that they haven't existed for nearly 6,000 years, but we can still see them. Sounds impossible, right? The paradox can be explained if we take a look at the properties of light. How do we see objects? We've learned from school that the light hits the object. The object then absorbs every wavelength except for one. This reflected wavelength then hits our eye and we see the object. What's often left out of this process is a crucial element, time. It takes time for the light to travel those distances. So in fact, everything that you are currently seeing is what it used to look like just in the past. In our everyday life, this doesn't really affect us because the distances between your eye and the other objects is relatively small. In the world, or should I say universe, of astronomy, however, everything must be taken into account. It takes light about 8 minutes to travel from the sun to the Earth. So if you happen to look at the sun, you'll see how it used to be 8 minutes ago. The picture that the Hubble took is what the pillars used to look like 7,000 years ago. The distance is so incredible, 66 quadrillion, 181 trillion, 449 billion, 600 million kilometers, that the amount of time does make a difference. So when we look up at the night sky, we're looking into the past, a primitive way of time travel. So take a look at the picture one more time. The Hubble Space Telescope took this photograph by analyzing the received light and converting it into a digital image. The light that it received was, in fact, the light that reflected off the pillars 7,000 years ago. That light has just arrived at Earth. This concept works the other way, too. Imagine that alien life exists within the pillars. If they took a look at Earth, then they would see our Neolithic ancestors in the process of inventing the wheel, 5,000 BCE. So how does this explain why the pillars don't exist anymore? Because of an exploding star or supernova. Astronomers think that a supernova and the resulting shockwave knocked down the pillars around 6,000 years ago. Since the pillars are 7,000 light years away, but were destroyed only 6,000 years ago, humans will continue to see the standing pillars for another 1,000 years. This is definitely a bit dramatized for effect, but you get the idea. Fast forward 1,000 years. Imagine our descendants looking up at the pillars and watching the scene. They will see the dramatic shockwave slowly approaching the pillars. They'll see the monumental pillars topple to the ground, annihilated by the force of a dead star. However, they will also realize that the scene actually took place a very, very, very long time ago. This is the beauty of astronomy. It completely redefines the way we look at the world around us. It humbles us by showing us how insignificant we truly are in the grand scheme of things, and yet it makes us feel privileged. Privileged because we've been given the opportunity to observe this incredible universe. We are merely spectators, relegated to the lowly role of simply watching and trying to make sense of the cosmos. But when the cosmos contains such beautiful sights, very much like the pillars of creation, well then, who can complain? This episode is brought to you by My Astronomy Channel. Subscribe to our channel and enjoy free weekly universe episodes.